In this problem, we're taking a definite integral from 0 to 1 over root 2 of the fraction x over square root 1 minus x to the fourth, and we're asked to perform this integral informally first by recognizing the chain rule backwards, and then we're asked to repeat the integral by using a formal U substitution. So absolutely the key to this one is to recognize that we're looking at something that fits the form of the derivative of an inverse sine function. So the derivative of the inverse sine is just 1 over the square root 1 minus x squared. And what I recognize here is that I could write this as 1 over the square root 1 minus something squared. It's 1 minus x squared squared. That makes the x squared the inner function here. And then I essentially have the derivative of that sitting in the numerator. It's missing a 2, but I have the right functional piece. So whenever you have a function of a function where you recognize that it's something you can get an antiderivative for, and it's sitting right next to the derivative of that inner function, you can see the results of the chain rule in this, and then just guess your way back to the antiderivative. So I do need to make this adjustment and say that 2x is the derivative of the inner function. And of course, I can't just go around throwing 2s into my integrals. I have to put a 1/2 in front to compensate for that. And now I can see that the antiderivative of my integrand is just going to be the inverse sine of x squared. And I still need to evaluate this thing across the limits of integration, 0 to 1 over root 2. Now, before I evaluate across the limits of integration, I just want to verify that I've guessed the right antiderivative here. All I have to do is differentiate it and make sure I get back to my original integrand. And the 1/2 is a spectator here. And the derivative of an inverse sine is, again, 1 over the square root of 1 minus its argument squared. So I treat x squared like it's just a single variable, and I differentiate with respect to that. And I get 1 over square root 1 minus x squared squared, which is x to the fourth. And then the chain rule says, now you've got to tack on the derivative of that argument with respect to x. That's a 2x. The 2s cancel, and I'm back to where I started. So I've got the right antiderivative here. Now to evaluate across the limits of integration, I plug in the upper limit. And when I replace x with 1 over root 2, I get 1 over root 2 squared, which is 1/2. And so my first piece here is the angle whose sine is 1/2. And I recognize that special angle. Then I subtract the angle whose sine is 0, which is 0, of course. So I have 1/2. The angle whose sine is 1/2. That's pi over 6. And I end up with pi over 12 as the final answer. Now moving on to part B, to use a formal U substitution, you still have to recognize basically what function you're looking at and what the inner function should be. So I still have to see that I'm basically looking at an inverse sine, and I'm going to say let U equal the inner function here, so that's x squared. Transform the differential, du is 2x dx. And I still have to play this game of getting that differential to appear properly in the integrand. So I've got to put that factor of 2 in there. And again, I've recognized, oh, this is like an inverse sine type of thing. So I'm going to express x to the fourth as x squared squared. Put a 1/2 in front to compensate for the 2 that I put in there. And now this piece I recognize as du. And this piece is a 1 minus u squared inside that square root. So I get 1/2 integral du over the square root of 1 minus u squared. And now it looks like the most basic inverse sine integral. Note on the limits of integration here that u does not go from 0 to 1 over root 2. Those were limits on x. And you have a choice here. You could just grind through your integral and then replace u with x at the very end and then evaluate across these original limits. Or I can transform my limits into u limits and then abandon x for the rest of the problem. Just to mix things up, I'm going to take that latter approach and I'm going to transform the limits of integration. So I go back to where I defined u and I said u is x squared. And that means when x is 0, that's my lower limit of integration, u is 0 squared, which is still 0. And it means when x is 1 over root 2, u is x squared, which is 1/2. So now I don't have to think about x's anymore. I'm just going to get a number out of this. And I have the basic form of the thing that integrates to inverse sine here. So I have inverse sine of u. And then I evaluate from 0 to 1 half. So I get 1 half the angle whose sine is 1 half minus the angle whose sine is 0. Again, that's 0. And the angle whose sine is 1 half is pi over 6. And 1 half of pi over 6 is, again, pi over 12. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.